Hey guys, I'm Kumesh, the co-founder and CEO of Aroomoogan. So pretty much what this talk is going to be about is how to bootstrap your tech startup or any other startup that you're trying to create. So startups are a big hype right now in our age. Everyone that has a little idea, the first thing they do is they run to investors and try to help them, which is the worst thing that you can possibly do. So what I'm going to tell you is once you have that idea, how you can go about and execute and get your first 100,000 of revenues for your idea, get your first few customers, and then go to investors and raise capital. So pretty much, so I'll tell you a little about my story. So we're pretty much doing AI and finance. So we're monitoring about 20 million websites, including Twitter. So all your Twitter feeds are scanning in real time. And we have AI algorithms to grasp which of these tweets or these articles are actually relevant to the stock market. Which of these tweets may have an impact on stock prices. And we send these tweets and these articles to large hedge funds and invest in bankers so you can execute and trade on that information in real time. So when we started the company, we didn't really have everything planned out. We just had a very simple idea. We were like, okay, what if we were to get this information first and then trade on the information, we would probably make a bunch of money. So we started with a very, very simple idea, and what it turns out was we had to pivot a lot and basically change our business model a lot until we got it right. So there's a turning point though in every single startup when you know that you are onto something. So, but before you even get to that, one of the ways to actually start a company is to bootstrap and using your limited resources as efficiently as possible. So when we started a company, we actually just created a website. We didn't have a product or anything. So we just created a really simple website. It took like, I don't know, 2 hours or so. And we just put the website out there. So this was basically our MVP. It's a minimal viable product. Just create like the simplest thing that you can do and try to get customers to come on your website and figure out if these customers actually like what you're doing. So we created a very simple website. Then all of a sudden, one of the largest hedge funds in New York came to our website, and the hedge fund manager was like, hey, your product looks pretty awesome. Can we get a trial of your product? And so I was sitting in the basement with my co-founder, and we looked at each other, and we were like, okay, we didn't have a product, what are we going to do? Because this is like one of the biggest hedge funds. And so what we did was we told the hedge fund manager that, hey, we're in the process of developing the product. Can we utilize your feedback and ask you some specific questions and we can tailor our product towards your liking? And that's when we started developing the actual product. So we started communicating with our first interesting potential customer and we started building the product towards his liking. Because we assumed that if we build our product towards his liking, then we can actually, then there's other people that's out there that may actually like our product. So we took a risk. Communicated with the hedge fund manager and integrated his feedback and create our first product. But to actually create the product, the first product, you need additional labor resources. So what we did was we couldn't afford to pay top engineers like hundreds of thousands of dollars. It was way too expensive. So what we did was we convinced these engineers to come on to our company by giving away equity. So it's giving away part of your company and maybe people, selling people on the vision and the dream of your company. So pretty much we got a lot of our talented engineers based off equity. And this was one of the best ways that a lot of early stage startups are going for now. It's the try to bootstrap as much as possible, spend as little cash as much as possible, and try to validate whether your product is actually working or not. So we got a bunch of engineers, we start building the product, and then once we build the product, we give it to the hedge fund manager, and he loved it. His entire team tested the product, they all loved it, and then it became our largest paying enterprise client 6 months after. So from creating the website, building that first MVP, so about 6 months after, we got our first largest client, and we used that revenue from the client to start repeating that same model again. So we were like, okay, this client loved our product. Let's find other clients similar to this client and sell our products to those clients. And so what we did, so this hedge fund, they were a quantitative hedge fund. So they do algo training. They feed real-time Twitter data and social media data to their algorithms and execute trading real-time. So we tried to find similar hedge funds like that who can actually use our product. And to do that, we used some of the revenues to scale up. So we actually hired performance-based sales consultants. So performance-based means that they're not getting a big salary, but they're making their money based off commissions. So instead of spending a lot of money hiring expensive sales guys, we actually paid them off commission. So if they were to sell to a hedge fund, they would get X percent commission. And it was a great model for us because we didn't have to spend a ton of cash at the start of the company. And so by hiring these performance-based consultants, they start reaching out to lots of other hedge funds that they know about, and we keep scaling the revenue stream from then on. Now, one of the best ways to actually start reaching out to your first few customers that we learned in Axer is actually use LinkedIn. So if you use LinkedIn Advanced Search, so our customer profile were quantitative hedge funds, and portfolio managers add those quantitative hedge funds. So what we did was we used LinkedIn, and we did use LinkedIn Advanced Search, and start looking for all these titles at large hedge funds, and we had like a list of 100,000 potential customers. And imagine if we were to close those 100,000 potential customers, that's a lot of revenues. So the thing is, we didn't have so much people to actually manually reach out to all of these guys. So what we did was we thought of innovative ways on how we could automate this entire process. So we used LinkedIn, and we got about 100,000 potential leads. And now what we did was we used this cool tool that's called Rocket Reach. And so Rocket Reach actually scans everyone's LinkedIn account, and it scans hundreds of data sets that's across the web, and it actually finds that person's email address. So now we have 100,000 quantitative hedge funds' email address at our fingertips, and we can easily reach out to them now. And the way, one of the most efficient way to spend your time in reaching out to these guys, instead of like emailing one by one, we use mail merge. So we automate the entire process with mail merge. And you have to use mail merge very carefully because sometimes they might think it's spam. If you write a very long mail merge, they will automatically know that you're just spamming them. You better tailor your mail merge such as maybe write just two sentences and then send this out to them. Make it a little personalized. And so that's what we did. We got a lot of potential customers from this entire process. This is cool. This is one of the best ways we bootstrap Axer. Didn't spend much money, got hundreds of thousands of revenues, and we closed our seed round a few weeks ago, actually. But before we closed our seed round, we had hundreds of thousands of revenues to show that traction growth for the company. And now, a lot of what investors care about a lot is how can you make X number of revenues within X number of months? So our Series A investor, which we're going to be closing maybe in about 6 months, they need to see a lot of revenue growth, and that's one of the only things they care about. They don't care about your idea that much. They just care about that revenue growth. And so, another interesting thing that we did early on in the startup was actually get hedge funds and our potential customers into very long contracts. So instead of giving them like a month-to-month payment, we actually told them, hey, you guys subscribe for about 1 year. So now they're locked into that contract. And instead of them paying you month to month, where you're getting that revenue stream month to month, we told them, hey, we'll give you like a 20% discount if you can give us the entire year of payment upfront. And so by doing that, we got tons of cash upfront, and we're able to utilize that cash to scale up the company as fast as possible instead of waiting for those other revenue streams. And so pretty much what we're doing now is repeating the same exact process that I've just taught you at Axon right now. We're hiring more sales consultants, reaching out to more potential customers, and just scaling up the revenues as much as possible. And once you start hitting that curve, that revenue curve, a lot of investors are just going to come straight at you and you're going to be like, hey, can I get into your Series A round? Your valuation is going to go skyrocket. So you just got to figure out who your customers are and tailor the focus towards that specific customer. But make sure you don't spend too much money and too much effort at the start, wasting a lot of time running all these different scenarios. But that's pretty much it. And thank you guys for coming here.